Hello everyone and welcome to Window to My Life with the still non-existent window that will probably never exist. Anyways, how have you all been doing? I've been okay, just not really much has happened to me as of late, just kind of living life day to day right now, so yeah. Anyways, I have a few things I want to talk about for this month's vlog, with some of it world news, some of it gaming news, some of it channel news, so yeah, just a bit of a variety. First off is the upcoming Black Friday, in about a little under a week now, since it's a Saturday before Thanksgiving. The main thing I want to say is just sorry to all the people having to work retail on Thanksgiving evening, through the night, and all day Friday, because so many people just want like ridiculously cheap deals that honestly aren't the best. So yes, hello Max. Yes, he just loves to be in the video. Yes. I know, you need attention. The walk I gave you earlier today was not enough. Anyway, so yeah, I feel sorry for those people who are going to be completely overrun by shoppers just demanding the best deals and stuff. I don't know, honestly, just remember this. The day after Thanksgiving is Buy Nothing Day. Remember, that's a holiday. Okay? That is the thing. So, why don't we just celebrate Buy Nothing Day? Please. For the sake of the poor people having to work on Thanksgiving and not being able to be with their families. Yes, and anyways, in other world news, there's the poor attacks on Paris. Just, yes, Max, yes. I feel sorry. It sickens me to see these people that go and they go and kill innocents just to try to show that they'll, I don't like terrorists, obviously. I mean, no one likes terrorists, except the terrorists themselves. And I know that not all Muslims are bad, obviously, because that would be stupid. I mean, saying that if you're a Muslim, you're a terrorist, it's like saying if you own a gun, you're going to go on a shooting rampage or something like that. So all those people saying that, they're idiots. But at the same time, it's just upsetting that groups like ISIS are going and repeatedly killing hundreds of innocent people just to try to cause panic and try to get people to just... I don't like it. It's just, I hope the people of Paris are safe and remain safe. I think they caught some of the people and the others died. I'm not entirely sure, I'd have to go and double check on that. But I hope the people of Paris are safe and nothing more comes from them. Because, I mean, this is the second time they've been attacked this year. They had the journalist that got the whole editing place that got blown up and shot down earlier this year because they were making satirical, I'm not sure how you say that, comics about Muslims, so they got killed. So yeah, poor Paris has suffered this year. So yeah, I pray that the people of Paris are able to remain safe through the remainder of this year and the next, and the people who, the hundreds of thousands of people who lost loved ones or friends that night, I pray that they may be able to find peace somehow, some way. Yeah. Anyways, let's see. Moving on, we have a few things for the channel here. As you may be aware, I mentioned the Don't Buy Anything Day earlier in the video here, but yeah, as you may know, the Bizarre Holiday series has ended for now. It just doesn't meet up to the standard of quality that I wish for my channel to have these days. I mean, the videos this year felt kind of underwhelming and more along the lines of what happened in the 2011 series, which for 2011 that was fine, but the 2013 and the first two-thirds of the 2014 series improved so much in the holiday series. It just, after I left college and people busy with their jobs. I was busy with my job, and just the holiday series started suffering. And I had the 5 holidays in 2015 just to kind of test it, see like, hey, will this series be able to work on its own? And I just don't feel like it really can. So yeah, the holiday series, like I said in the final video, it may come back several years down the line if I ever have the chance to be able to do what I did in the 2013 and first part of the 2014 series again, with having multiple people and different skits. But if I'm not doing that, if I'm not able to do that, then I honestly would just keep the holiday series as it is and not run it into the ground. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the holiday series though, because it was fun. And just remember to celebrate the holiday series. Just don't forget it, because that was one of my favorite things to do on this channel, for the most part. One of the only real major things in this channel outside the vlogs here that didn't actually have anything to do with video games, really, except for the video game day. Okay, it occasionally did stuff with video games. It was one of the few things that didn't really exclusively focus on video games. So, yeah. Excuse me one moment. Sorry about that, it was just my parents calling. So, anyways, I think I said everything I wanted to say about the holiday series, so I'll go on to the Let's Plays, which is finally coming back. I mean, yeah, after kind of struggling some to bring them back and just kind of being down, I'm still working on Kirby 64. I've been having trouble finding the motivation to fix the commentary for Kirby 64's. Which is why I went back to finally making new episodes of Chrono Trigger, because I figured if I did that, then I could kind of reinvigorate my love for Let's Playing and be able to get the energy and motivation to fix Kirby 64. And so far, it's worked, yeah. Playing Chrono Trigger again just kind of revived my love for Let's Playing, which is kind of fizzled, the fire kind of fizzled down to just a few embers on the charcoal sort of thing. So I'm working on Kirby 64. For real, and actually getting the motivation to go and fix the commentary. So hopefully Kirby 64 will return soon. Hopefully, I hope to finish that by the end of this year. And Chrono Trigger, it's a blind Let's Play, so maybe it's kind of going on a year now since Chrono Trigger started. I would like it to wrap up somewhat soon, but at the same time, I can't tell how much longer I have to go because I've never played the game before. So yeah. Anyways, on with the stuff. Let's see, there's just one thing quickly. Splatoon. Awesome game. Fun characters. Fun playing. Nice amiibo. But just one thing, just please help spread the word. For Nintendo. We have 13 stages, soon to be 14 when that stage that takes place in the middle of a pool comes out. But the thing is that outside of Splatfest, we only have 2 stages for each mode. So like if I want to play a Turf War, I'll go online and I'll say I'll have Walleye Warehouse and Urchin Underpass. And those are the only 2 stages I can play on. But that's the thing is, once the stage in the swimming pool comes out, we'll have 14 stages that we can only play 2 of at a time. That's a 1/7 of all the stages available. That's it. What I'm hoping is just people try to help spread the word here is I want to be able to just see when Splatoon has like its final updates and stuff that apparently are coming in January, just to have 3 stages at all times, like in the Splatfest. Like the Splatfest, that's cool, but at least 3 stages, so we have 3 at a time out of 14, would be better than 1/7 of the stages, and that's it. I mean, sure, I know the ranked battles have different stages, generally, from the Turf Wars. But at the same time, not everyone plays ranked, and not everyone plays the normal Turf Wars. That's the thing. So, yeah. Now, moving on, we have... Let's see, took care of you. Okay, 2 things. We have... Today is the 1-year anniversary of the release of Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, and the Wii U version of Super Smash Bros. Brawl. And most importantly, the 1-year anniversary of the release of the initial wave of Amiibo. Excuse me. And what a crazy rollercoaster of a year it has been. I mean, started with me after Christmas, I got a gift card to GameStop for $20, so I tested it out by getting the Link and Kirby amiibos here, and well, for something I didn't think was that interesting, and I just bought two just to test the waters, I have 24 amiibo right now, 21 from the Super Smash Bros. Series plus the 3 Splatoon amiibos, and I'm waiting on the Roy and Midna and Wolf Link amiibos to come out. So yeah, I mean, I don't care to collect all of the amiibo, and I can definitely cannot afford to. Okay, well, I probably could, but it would kill my wallet, or bring it to Neodeath, so I'm not. But yeah, I like the amiibo, actually. It's fun to collect them, plus fun to have little figurines just kind of sitting on your shelf, like Mr. Game & Watch here, just kind of sitting there, cool. Plus, I like how this one's interchangeable. So yeah, it's been a crazy year, though, with the Nintendo underestimating the amount of amiibo that people would want at the start, and then the port strikes on the West Coast kind of delaying the rest of the amiibo, just kind of causing them to come out in small quantities. And it was rough at first, but Nintendo's definitely turned themselves around. The port strike's been long over, and Nintendo's definitely been doing a good job at reprinting amiibo and printing a lot more of them, but honestly, I can kind of see how they may have underestimated it, because looking at the financial reports that Nintendo showed off a month or two ago, approximately, of all the amiibo sales worldwide, two-thirds of all sales for amiibo, if not more, for the entire planet, are in North America. Yeah. The remaining 33% or so was Japan, Australia, and the entirety of Europe. So yeah, that's how insanely popular the amiibos are here in America. Possibly because, well, I mean, for about $12 here in store, you can go and get a little Darkbit figurine that actually works with your games. So yeah, that's probably why they became so freaking popular, because, I mean, they're not that expensive unless you had to deal with the scalpers online, but thankfully that's pretty much a thing of the past. Speaking of which, don't buy amiibos at conventions, because, I mean, I've been to a few conventions, and I've seen things like Bowser Jr. amiibos. It's like, how much does that cost? I'm like, oh, well, it's super rare, so it's $45. I'm like, in my head, I was like, okay. And in my head, I'm like, yeah, I saw it on Amazon yesterday for $18. No, not buying. So, it's been a year of amiibos, and we have almost 90 amiibo already for just 1 year, and more on the way. It is crazy, but hey, it's a cool little way of the toys to life, plus I think what I like this one, I like about the amiibo more than Skylanders, Disney Infinity, and Lego Dimensions, is you don't actually need the amiibos. They're more of an optional thing, which I guess is a double-edged sword, as some people like me are happy they're not necessary, while others are complaining that they don't have enough use. I don't know. It's a interesting balance, and man, it's windy out there. I don't know, it's been really windy all day. And then finally, last note is, according to what I've been seeing on the internet today, is also Eevee Day. Why, I'm not sure. As of trying to look it up, I couldn't find out any reasons, but, well, I'm not complaining, because I love the Eeveelutions, and honestly, the only real complaints I have about Eevee and its evolutions is that there are more than 6 of them, so you can't fit them all in the party at the same time. That's the only shortcoming they have these days. But honestly, yeah, I like the Eeveelutions here. I mean, I have Glaceon and Sylveon plushies, little Umbreon and Espeon figurines, and been looking for good plushies of the rest of them. So yeah, Eevee Day. Because why not? No pun on the Pokemon intended. Anyways, so yeah, that's pretty much all I had to talk about. This vlog's probably gone on for a long time. Hello. My vlogs tend to ramble on anyways, because it's just me vlogging, just saying what's on my mind. So yeah, anyways, this is Gotablaze. I hope to see you around sometime on another video of mine. So yeah, window into my life, and I'll see you next time. Bye.